I hope you have watched the video I sent last time. It was chapter 5, the 100 dresses part 1. If not, you must watch it again. If you haven't understood, you may ask the queries. Okay, today you must have done the NCERT questions as well. If not, try it. For any doubt, you may ask anytime. Today I'm going to give you some tips how we can write character sketch. Okay, there are three main characters we have read in this chapter part 1. First we discuss the title of the chapter, then we discuss the character sketches how. Because title is always important of any chapter. Okay, you may be asked in CBSE, a number of times it's asked that okay, justify the title of the chapter. Then what you have to tell, like that title was the 100 dresses. And if you have observed most of the chapter, most of the things when Peggy and Wanda were talking with Peggy and her friends, when they were talking with Wanda, they were talking about her dress, her shoe, her dress. Most of the times they were pointing out to her dress because they did not like the way she dressed up and they did not like the way, according to them, she boasted for that she was having a number of dresses. So this whole, the title revolves, the story revolves around this title, the 100 dresses. Okay, this is very important because the theme is also same, 100 dresses, it depends on, because bullying by bullying, so they got that main idea, they mocked over the main idea that she was always boasting for her dress, so they picked up that particular point only about the dress and they keep on mocking and exaggerating that thing. Okay, so this you can tell about the title. So now let us discuss, there were three main characters. One was Wanda, another was Peggy, and the third one was Maddie. Peggy and Maddie, these two were friends. Okay, do you remember? Okay, these were friends, and Wanda, if you remember, she was a poor girl, outcast child who was not liked by other girls because she all didn't have good clothes to wear and she was having only one faded dress. So she was outcast child who did not have any friend. Okay, this is what we read in the chapter. Now, if we see from the point of view of these two girls or other class, she is just an outcast and a dirty girl who did not look good in her bad clothes, in dirty clothes, in faded dress. Okay, but if we see from a reader's point of view, she is having a number of qualities. What were those qualities? Wanda was, she was generous, a kind-hearted girl, a very generous, very polite. Although others were bullying her, the girls were bullying her, the class was bullying her while playing in the ground, while sitting in the class, but she did not say anything to anyone. She was very generous and very polite to all. Then she was very serene. Serene is, she was very calm, cool-hearted. Though she was being teased, she may have lost the control, but she did not. Okay, so this is her most important quality. Then she was talented. Was she? Yes, she was talented. She made so many paintings, 100 paintings she made. And what actually she talked about her dresses, she visualized that scene in her mind and she made that exact painting for the blue dress, green dress or other color. Okay, this was her particular quality. Another was, she was skilled, talented as well as skilled. She knew how to use her talent, how to use her imagination into that particular field. She was very able for that. She did it. Forgiving? Was she forgiving? Yes, she was. Though other tea children, they used to. Even you will read the chapter, next part of this, you will read out that she was so forgiving, so good girl, so that she forgave even those bad girls, bad students who misbehaved with her. So she was forgiving. And she was a patient girl. We have seen throughout the chapter, patience is being seen in her. She did not say any wrong words to anyone. She did not defend to anyone, though she did not lose control also. But she keep on improving upon her skills. Okay? Slowly. Now, she was highly sensitive girl, very highly sensitive. She felt, she did not say anything to anyone. She may have lost temper, she may have become depressed, but no, she did not. Because she was very highly sensitive. She knew those girls, they were mocking at me. So what made those mocks, those negative things she was getting, she saw the opportunity in those also. And whatever they say, she made it her skill. how she made the dresses. She moved over her dresses. She made her dresses in the form of paintings. So this was about Wanda, a very good girl who is having skill also, who is patient also, and who tolerated all the things but did not lose temper. Okay, this is about Wanda. You can write down. Now the second main character, it was Peggy. Peggy also, as we all know, she was very famous in the class. Was she? Yes, she was very famous. She was the girl who was liked by everyone. The reason was because maybe she was rich also, very having good clothes also for wearing, and most important, she was liked by all for her qualities also. Okay, not only for clothes that she was rich, for qualities also. But she was naughty, a little bit naughty she was. She made fun of Wanda. Did she? Yes, she made fun of Wanda, and she justifies that fun. What? Because she thought that Wanda was a liar girl. She was speaking a lie because she was wearing all the time, she was wearing one faded dress. And then she said that she's having 100 dresses. So she thought she is making fun of a liar. So this is not wrong. This was her point of view. Okay, but she was kind-hearted. How? Can you tell she was kind-hearted? If you remember, you have read in the chapter, she loved the animals. Whenever she saw any cruelty happening, any cruelty to the animals, she was deeply sensitive at that moment. She tried to defend those animals. She tried to save those animals from others. Okay? So this was her qualities. And not only for animals, she was sentimental also. Whenever any small child, any younger one of her, any classmate or any other one, not classmate, the younger children, and they were bullied by other people, what she did? She stopped them. She had that courage. She stopped them. Only in case of Wanda, she was bad. Otherwise, she was good and sentimental girl. Intelligent, as we have read in the chapter, she scored very good marks. And she, her drawings, paintings, she was were very good. She was also skilled. She was good, but not as good as Wanda was. But she was very good in paintings. If Wanda would have not been there, maybe she would have been the winner of those paintings which the children made in that class. Okay, these are her qualities. And she was very attractive. She was attractive, good looking. That's why children, most of the time, they praised her. And a good friend of Maddie. Okay, this is about Peggy. Though she was making fun of Wanda, this was only negative trait of her. Otherwise, she was good, kind-hearted, sentimental also. So we have to take both the points of this girl, negative also, positive also. Okay, so this is about Peggy. Now we come to third character, that is Maddie. Maddie, she was friend of Peggy, but she was as poor as Wanda. She was not from a rich family, and she's as poor as she was, though not so much, though not so extreme, but she was poor. Okay, now, she was a poor girl, we have discussed this point, and she was highly sensitive girl. She was also sensitive like Wanda. Okay, how she was sensitive? When Wanda was being hurt by others, being teased by others, this girl, Maddie, she felt very bad. What she felt? She said, I am also as poor as she is. If any other child make fun of me, so what will happen? Will I feel good? No. So these sort of things she keep on thinking in her mind. She tried, but the only thing was that she did not try to stop others, not to bully this girl, one. So, she was emotional as well, emotional in the sense because she was a friend of Peggy. She was feeling emotions for this girl also, but because Peggy was her best friend and she loved this girl very much, she did not lose a friendship with her. Because she was a poor girl, she was a rich girl, and she used to wear the clothes of Peggy itself after being altered by her mother. So she was very emotional, she does not want to lose a friendship with this girl. So for that she always took care. So for that she allowed the cruelty with this girl, Wanda. So this again here, positive qualities also, negative qualities are also coming in the girl. Now she was a good friend because she was a good friend of Peggy, and for the friendship's sake she could do anything. She could even indirectly she was involved in the wrong task. Indirectly in the wrong thing she was involved. She allowed the children to laugh over Wanda, which should not have been done by her. and now she was guilty. After all these things when were happening, she was feeling guilt for that. And when you will read out in part 2 of the chapter, you will found out that is how this sense of guilt overpowered her, how she then made up her mind that she will not allow anyone to do anything wrong with Anicca. Okay, so this is all about these three characters we have read in chapter 1. Some more will be added here from the part 2 of this chapter. Same chapter will be there, part 2, 100 verses, chapter 6, when we will read out. Okay, so I hope this will help. These points will help you out to write the character sketch in a perfect way. Add your own point, what you thought, what was negative in her, what was positive in the girls. You can add more things after reading next chapter also. You can add more and justify the title also. These all the three characters you have to write in the fair notebook and justify the title, how this title is apt to the chapter. Clear? So now this, I hope you will understood, you have understood, you have taken all these points. You may note down these as these are given. I will send you a copy so you can just note down all the points in your fair notebooks as well. Okay, best of luck.